Julia, how are you doing? We actually did an interview with MTV.
Yes.
Okay, I've seen the movie now. Oh my God.
You do?
Yeah. So it must have been a lot of fun filming that.
It was so fun. I mean, it was literally one of the most fun experiences of my life because you just have so many people and like they're key people your age and your age range hanging around and working really hard and feeling so passionately about their characters and having a lot of downtime. So it's like this awesome combination of like working hard and playing hard.
That's always nice. Now, I know at the junket, I was watching you. You got really choked up when you were talking about the Native Americans and the being accepted and all that. Why are you still so emotional about that? What really gets to you?
I mean, even when I think about it just now, it's like, it's such an honor. I don't know if you've ever been in a position to change people's lives or to feel like you are impacting people, children's lives especially, but like I have talked to kids and I've met kids who, like they literally, that you can watch their world expand because somebody that looks like them is like, it's like there aren't very many of us, you know, and I don't feel a burden, I don't feel like, it doesn't feel like weight to me, it feels like just, I mean, overwhelming sometimes, but...
Well, do you think this movie, it's a vampire movie, yet it's going to open up doors for more Native American actors, don't you think?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean,
so isn't it kind of strange that a teenage vampire movie is what is getting this out there, is making this more mainstream?
Yeah, I mean, if you actually break it down, there are reasons for there are reasons, but yeah, it does seem strange.
And Jonah Hex.
Yes.
You get to play Josh Brolin's wife. Hello.
I know.
Lucky lady.
I know.
So you get killed, but still, you get to play it. What was that set like?
That was like very, very different from Twilight. It was kind of condensed, very sort of specific, quiet, focused set. And I don't know, it was almost like a conservatory. Everybody was just so doing their own thing and coming, and I think there was a lot of trust on that set. Like everybody trusted everybody else to know what they're doing and to sort of be at the top of their game, which of course they were, and so it just kind of rolled along, you know, like a lot was expected and so you just sort of showed up.
Nice. Well, that's good.
Yeah.
Different than playing a werewolf.
Yes, and all the chaos of 45 characters in the middle of nowhere, you know, running around and doing whatever they're doing in their off time.